the Bible Clan Series 3. This week's people group is the Gibeonites.
The Gibeonites are the inhabitants of Gibeon. They are also called the Hivites or the Amorites.
Gibeon was a Canaanite city. The Lord God commanded as a law to destroy completely all the inhabitants of Canaan.
As the Israelites were moving forward in this conquest, the Gibeonites were very much afraid. The Gibeonites knew this law. They were afraid because of the Lord God and of his fame and because of the people of Israel.
Though Gibeon was a great and royal city, though all its men were mighty, they did not want to trust in their might, rather sought peace.
In order to save their lives, they disguised as ambassadors from a distant land and covenanted with Israel.
On the third day, the Israelites found out that they were being deceived by the Gibeonites, who were actually their neighbors.
However, because of the covenant, the Gibeonites were let to live in exchange for their servitude as woodcutters and water carriers.
Sooner, the other five Amorite kings heard of the peace treaty and gathered together to war against them.
But amid miraculous circumstances, including hailstones and the suspension of the sun and moon, the Amorites were totally destroyed by the Israelites.
Nearly 400 years later, after Joshua's time, King Saul violated the covenant and killed some Gibeonites. He also planned to kill the rest.
As a result, during King David's reign, there was a three-year drought. When inquired, it was revealed as a divine judgment against Saul's decision to kill the Gibeonites.
To make amends, the lives of seven sons of Saul were given to the Gibeonites. Thus, the covenant stood firm.
According to the law, the Gibeonites did not deserve to live, but they received grace through the covenant.
Nearly 1,000 years later, this grace did bear fruit. After exile, they showed their gratitude and servitude by rebuilding the walls of Jerusalem. Eventually, they were assimilated into Israel. The outsiders became the insiders.
Joshua's covenant outruled the law and gave life. Lord Yeshua's blood covenant gives us life, covers us from harm, and does miracles when required.
Just as the Gibeonites, we need to understand the power of God, show humbleness, and accept the need of salvation through the blood covenant. We need to submit ourselves to serve the Lord. The faithful, good God will go to any lengths to keep the covenant with us.
Let's enter and serve the Holy of Holies by the blood of Jesus.
Let's be Christ in action throughout this week. Bye, friends.